Rocky Mountain region is usually known for its beauty. Picturesque landscape seems to dominate visions when one thinks of Colorado in particular. But that's changing in a big way. Now thoughts are also turning to basketball, college basketball, and the powerhouse quietly being built at Colorado State University. The architect, head coach Boyd Tiny Grant. Before Grant returned to coach at his alma mater, the Ram basketball program had kind of coasted along, not really going slower, but not going much faster either. But when Grant made his move back to Fort Collins, it was obvious he was planning to implement a tiny bit of magic. In his first season with the Rams, 1987-88, the Rams rocked the college basketball world by reaching the Final Four of the National Invitation Tournament in New York. But the next question was, how will they top that? Well, for starters, before the ball was even tossed up to start the 1988-89 season, the answer was quite clear, and that was to win the rugged Western Athletic Conference. And a preseason poll of WAC head coaches picked the Rams to do just that.
Being picked high in the conference is not a minus to our program. I think it's a plus. I think it gives us something that we have to try to live up to, which will not be easy, and because I think we play in a very good conference. But I think it was a big thing for our program. I like it.
So by the time preseason practices began, the players were itching to get started. They took the court on the fly. It was Moby Midnight Madness, with practice officially beginning at 12:01 a.m. inside the Rams' own Moby Arena. Prepared for their conference season with a number of non-conference games, and one of the highlights of those was the game with the University of Colorado. It took place at Moby Arena, where a sellout crowd saw an interstate battle they'd never forget. Came a wild, wild win over Oral Roberts University. It featured the Rams topping the 100-point level. And in the end, the 102-89 final had CSU in top form for the WAC season. And that season opened with a tough road trip at San Diego State and at Hawaii in Honolulu. The Rams gained a split in those two games and headed back home to Fort Collins to face the University of New Mexico. And if there's any one game which was symbolic of the entire 88-89 season, this was it. After nearly 40 minutes of nip-and-tuck basketball, the Rams found themselves tied and without the basketball in the waning moments. But somehow, they found a way to win. In their next two games, a road victory at Air Force and a home win over Utah, the Rams sat at 4-1 in the conference, and sailing was smooth. But then the ceiling temporarily caved in. Losses to Brigham Young and Texas El Paso were followed by another thriller with New Mexico, this one at the Pit in Albuquerque, as the Rams looked to sweep their season series with the Lobos. This basket late in the game by Colorado State's Joel Triplehorn capped a comeback and sent the game into overtime, but the final score went with New Mexico, and the Rams were on the ropes. There comes a point in every team's season that's make or break. And for Colorado State, the question was whether they could answer the bell after three consecutive losses. And there's nothing better to cure the ills than home cooking. And for CSU, that meant five straight conference games at home, where the 10,500-seat Moby Arena plays home to one of the craziest crowds in all of college basketball. And with the fans behind them, the Rams toppled San Diego State by 20 and Wyoming by 10. And when they trailed by a point to Hawaii in the final seconds, the Rams looked for another big play to keep their championship hopes alive.
Oh, he throws it away! Triplehorn! He could give him the lead! From behind, if we got an intent.
intentional.
A pair of free throws followed. And when the game was on the line in the final seconds, it was the Ram defense that came to the rescue.
Boy, this defense is impressive, isn't it? They have 6 seconds. Ball's going to have to do something. Stolen by Tippett. They have it. An intentional foul, but it won't matter.
Won't make any difference.
Second win over Air Force followed, and then came an emotion-charged win over Texas El Paso. Two nights later, a win over Wyoming in Laramie not only raised the Rams' conference mark to 10-4, it also meant that Boyd Grant's crew had gone undefeated during the month of February for the second consecutive season. And when the Rams swept their last two road games of the season, including the finale against Brigham Young in Provo, the fans rolled out the red carpet in honor of the new WAC champs. Number one in a conference ranked the best west of the Mississippi. Postseason tournament, where the Rams beat both Utah and Hawaii for the third time in the same season, making it 11 wins in a row. That's the longest such streak in the country for last season. Despite a loss to Texas El Paso in the tournament final, the NCAA tournament committee came calling, and the Rams were in the magic round of 64. Colorado State's opening game in the NCAA's West Regional came in Dallas, where the Rams faced off with the University of Florida. The Gators were stunned by the Rams' style of tenacious defense and wide-open offense, and soon the rout was on. And when the horn sounded on a 68-46 win, the Rams found themselves in the final 32.
The folks out there in the Rocky Mountain country...
While the season ended the following game against Syracuse, the Rams had already assured themselves of their winningest season ever. The 23 victories set a new school mark and meant the Rams had won 45 games over the last two seasons. So what else did the season mean? Well, for guard Joel Triplehorn, he finished the season near the top of national statistics in three-point field goal accuracy, leading a fierce outside shooting attack. Forward Pat Durham was picked by the Dallas Mavericks in the NBA draft, the fifth player Boyd Grant has sent on to the pros. And for Grant himself, he received a four-year contract extension. Not bad for the 10th winningest active coach in all of college basketball. And it's not done with mirrors, but with teaching and with dedication to the game. And for fans of Colorado State, it has meant a return to glory. So the future of Colorado State basketball remains bright, and the sky remains the limit. Thank you.